penso apa, a me pisa.
Are you normal?
people that are playing. See, hey. Okay.
The lad, they don't play that problem.
She's not the one. He's the crew.
When I want for sure, let's go ask.
Well, I know what it is. How they be in the grand finale. Well, I know what it is. Saturday, we get here. Yeah. We don't go anywhere.
Chance,
the last day.
What's
happening now? God damn it. Oh, God.
Back to square zero.
Back to square
zero. Zero, zero,
one.
No, one is not allowed. 0.00.
Even
zero,
if
we have
a player coming over us, we must stop our rights. We must eat our rights. I don't see the one now. We don't see the eyes. I just look at you.
All right, so this vision, nothing like head of us sit down. Right?
Yes, sir.
Who's head of us?
Yeah.
Okay. Congrats, but no thanks because you don't have any immunity as head of us. Everybody, stand up. Hmm. I would still like you guys to play this song.
No, don't want to play.
Just play it for a second.
Oh, my heart is already shaking. They play song like 1 million times today. Our heart is in our mouth. It's beating.
Just play it. I guess all your bags are packed, right?
Yes.
It's okay. Just leave it like that.
Wash away all the pain of yesterday. Now my kingdom awaits.
They
forgive all my mistakes. I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. All right. Baby Bess. You're safe. Can you play the song again?
Oh my God.
Oh God.
I never felt so strong. Back feeling like there's nothing that I can't try.
Oluwaseun. How are you?
Very good. Always good.
Okay. MNK. It's the end of the road for you.
Jesus.
MNK has been a fake housemate.
I don't trust you.
I see you so much.
I see you. Oh, Riva!
Yes,
what else?
My tea!
Yes,
you. Yes, you.
Yes, you.
Hug up, guys.
Riva!
Love you!
Life like a knife.
You have been evicted.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank
you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
My honorable.
Hey! I will still send your security to lock you outside.
Nice. Honorable.
Well done.
Wow. It's spicy.
Sir?
Yeah. You are safe.
Spicy.
Okay.
Johnny Brew.
Steve.
You are evicted.
Jesus!
Johnny Bro.
Johnny Bro. What the F?
Like I said earlier, I don't know what happened. I don't know. But just feel in the next few days, we'll celebrate for one person.
Yes.
That one person will stand up. That one person will be the winner of the gang reality show season 3. We'll repeat the cash prize, all expense paid trip, an SUV, and a future in the movie. With more and more. Okay, back to the business. Dara. You're safe. Dan Cody. You're ready, thank you.
Wash away all the pain of yesterday.
Oh my God.
prediction,
Okay, we have left Francis Doe, Black Attitude and Comfort. You can hold your hands.
I'm coming home.
Francis Joe. It's the end of the word for you.
I love you. God damn it.
How are you, Comfort and Black Attitude? Why are you shaking? Black Attitude. You're safe. Sorry? Comfort. Congratulations, you're safe.
Thank you, sir.
We have AJ Spicy, Jessica,
that's me.
Black Attitude,
well,
Dara.
Oh,
baby Bess and Comfort. It's gonna be a fun week for you guys. Yeah, it's gonna be a fun week for you guys. You'll enjoy the whole apartment. You can stay too. But it's gonna be a very tough one. Because the gang master and the gang lord have to come up with another eviction. Congrats once more.
Thank you, sir.
There's no last guy standing, right? Like I just say, the game just began.
Hello viewers, my name is MNK Progress Bruce, and I just got evicted from the Gang Reality Show Season 3. Actually got evicted as the fake housemate, so we're outside.
So how's life been for you as a fake housemate in the
house? Life was very great because I had no worries. I was not scared of anything because I knew I had nothing to lose. So I was just doing my thing, like bonding, enjoying life, eating food. Actually had a very wonderful time, and I got to involve myself in the attacks, and actually saw a better part of myself I never even knew. So it's actually a very wonderful experience. Okay, my most wild experience. Okay, I think that was the day we were playing Truth or Dare, and Baby Bess had to pick Priceless Jewel and ask for the keys. I was really wild. I was like, wow. Like, I never saw that coming. Like, it was a very crazy experience, truth be told. Like, I think that was one of the things I saw that actually got me really, really surprised in the house. Like, I didn't see that coming, and I was wild, yeah. No, no. Okay, actually, when I go into the house, I was not close with some certain people. Even before they got evicted, like, their shine, Prier, we didn't actually have any bond. Like, we just get ourselves past. So, I was not really friends with them. But with this housemate, like the ones that are presently in the house and the ones that just left, I think I'm cool with everyone. Like, I'm very cool with everyone. Well, cool. I don't have a list. I'm okay with everyone. But I had people I was really like, people I never got the opportunity to talk to. That was Shine, Prier, and others. But the ones in the house presently, they're my G. We've bonded so much. Fall in love. No. I got love for everyone. Like, normal friendship love. But nothing serious anyone now. No. But I actually had someone I was really liking. Yeah, like, we're really cool. But then she left the show the next day after we started bonding much, and that was Sylvia. So we're actually like close. Like, she was the first, aside Black, I think she was the other person I was really close to. That was the first week before what happened, so she had to leave the house. But it's not love though, it's just closeness and vibes. Okay, moving forward, I'll go back to my business. I'm actually a fashion designer in Abuja. I own my own clothing brand. Waverwear, like everything I've put on the show since the start, everything from head to toe, like that my brand. So I'll just go out there, push the brand, get more. I'm sure this show is actually going to give me more exposure because I know that a lot of people that I don't even know that is watching, and if they are really, really observant enough, they should see that I have this particular thing I'm always putting on, which is Guava. So I think maybe probably like the show helped me like reaching out to larger audience. So I know definitely this show have a lot of benefits to my business. So I'll just go out there, continue my business, keep doing my thing, keep being the graver than I am, push the brand, basically.
Ah, God. I made it to the finals, God.
I feel great. No regrets. 100% great. It is what it is. Basically, I don't really have any favorable experience in the house. For me, just like I used to tell people in the house, relationship is number one thing for me. I'm very 100%. No matter what you say about me, I don't say it. I don't care. Because one thing that standard I used to tell my housemate, coming together of 21 housemates, we are to learn something here, and we are to learn something from each other. Because contact, bait, impact. So for me, I've been able to see people for who they are, and they've been able to see me for who I am. My brother, 1 month's love is lost for me. I don't do that. For me, I don't do that. Viewers, just like I said when I entered into this house, I'm into real estate. I'm a builder. I'm a dealer. So the best thing you could expect now is to see Okpawo Oluwaseun Estate in Lagos, in Abuja, in every other place. That is my prayer. And that is what I'm working on, by God's grace. God help me. Amen.
She was like, you're a fake house. There's nothing else to
tell. She was saying, this is a fake. I'm like, who tell you? She and me, too, to talk. Too, to the light of.
Hey. If I'm...
I'm 6. Is it a miracle from God?
Hi guys, my name is Frances Joe and I just got evicted from the gang reality show. My experience was a roller coaster, trust me. I made real genuine connections. I made friends. I got to see life differently. Trust me, I had a blast. It was fun. No regrets so far. Positive energy moving forward. Of course I did. I was so close to Priye before he left. We had some sort of bond, and it's something I still think I want to try outside of the house. Let's see how it goes. Trust me, every day was a vibe for me, back to back, good energy. I was life of the party. They'll tell you now. Trust me, every day was fun for me. I won't say least favorite. I think I vibed with literally everybody in the house. But definitely in the beginning, it was a bit rough. I am black, we were not really cool, but later on, we became so cool and we're good. We're such in a good place right now and I care for her a lot, actually. I don't think I have any least favorite. Oh, that's true, Victoria. I don't have any hate for her. When she left, I was actually so sad. Well, I wish her all the best. No hate. It's all love from this side. Yes, so I got to find out so much about myself in here. I want to go into acting, skit making. I want to be a very big entrepreneur, you know? Like, just expect a lot from me, from this side. A lot.
Are you serious?
Yeah, Ada. See, you see how I've never packed my bag like this and carry my hand back put on top that I'm going. Yesterday, if you see me out my manager, I see. I got people, they don't even mind you.
That's how it is. That you expect
mind. Yesterday, they don't even
mind. People that you expect to come through for you.
What happened? Yeah.
They are there. I want to even say bye to them. Even before.
Hi, my name is Ofunshu Daniel, aka Dan Cordier. Alright, I've just been evicted from the Gang reality TV show. Yeah, that is it. I think it's the flexing and everything in the house, but I'll be fine. Yeah, it's a roller coaster one. Like, I really enjoyed the show. Every bit of the show I enjoyed is starting from my fellow housemates, the tax. Like, every bit of the show, I really enjoyed it. Bonding with friends, like, you know, everything about the show, yeah. Including the gym aspect, the aerobic aspects, is on point. Eric and Tiana, you guys are good. You guys are good. I love you guys. What's up? Yeah, you guys are good. So the bomb, like, for how many weeks I've been in the house, like, but coming out for our hangout yesterday, it was fun. I was very happy. I was really, really happy. Like seeing water around, seeing people around, like, yo, it's a great one. I wish I can do that again with Breeze production. I'm really happy, yeah. I fall in love with somebody in the house, but I think in the house, but when I get outside, we'll know what's up, if it's continue or not. A big one, a big shot from Dan Cordier based on the acting line, because I'm into acting, you know. When you watch Akpan and Odume, when you watch Papa Jasko, Superstar in the Race, you see me there. But like this, I'm pushing harder now. My last word for my fellow gangmates which are sitting in the house, I wish you guys all the best. I mean all the best, starting from AG Spice, Black Attitude, Comfort, their baby best one name, Pino. I wish you guys all the best. I make sure you guys, please, and the best man should win the show. I root for you guys, man. I'm gonna miss you guys for that little couple of days. I'm gonna miss you guys. I love you guys. I want Jessica Gogoyin, I didn't miss now. Or join. It is what it is.
Classic Makeup USA brings to you the incredible Pro Ultra Wear Foundation.
Previously, I've always had issues finding my perfect foundation shade
because it would either be too light,
the color was always different for my skin.
So this has been a challenge until I found Classic Makeup.
100% flawless, confident, smooth.
The Pro Ultra Wear Foundation has been carefully designed to give you that extreme long wear and flawless finish that every classic woman deserves.
You should actually be out there because it's nice. It feels just like skin.
Shop our exciting range of 14 awesome shades with beautiful undertones and experience the beauty of foundation that feels just like skin.
Hi, I'm Johnny Bro. And I'm been evicted from the gang house. Mixed feelings. I'm not happy, but just okay, just there. I'm actually missing my girlfriend, E.G. Spice. Anyways, I'm kind of like a soft kind of person, and she's really out there. That's what I like about her. She's like outspoken, doesn't hide anything, always says her mind, you know. Okay, my most fun experience in the house was actually the movie. When we had to make the movie, it was stressful, but it was fun at the end of the day. We were very taxed and everything just went okay and we had fun at the end of the day. Experience as a gang leader, it is not easy talking to a bunch of adults. You must always have a bunch someone in the mix that's just not wanting to let you undo your position well. Just stress, not answering, or it's not easy. But it was okay. Stressful, but it was good. Actually, I don't have any least favorite people. Everyone knows me, I'm a man of peace. So,
and top favorite?
Top favorite, definitely AG Spicy. Then let's say Baby Best, followed by Jessica, Black Attitude, Diara, Comfort. These are the people that are still left in the house. My guys got evicted with me, Dan Cordier, everyone. Basically, everyone was just my friend. I really didn't have anyone I didn't like. I'm rooting for AG Spicy, definitely. No cap. Yeah, expect to see me more. I actually found out I have a talent for script writing and novel writing in the house. So I think I'll dive into that area, but I will still go into my business as usual. And I'm actually finding a way to plan to move to Lagos because I live in Abuja. So I'll see where it takes me from there.
Hello. Oh my God, come for.
Bye guys.
Bye.
God damn it!
God damn it!
God damn it!
God damn it!
But they are picking up now.
Are you not elementary? Wait, who's that cup? There's a cup here. That cup.
That red cup.
He was even the one that now said, because of that, he now said we should leave there. You know, everybody.
If I would.
I was John that was explaining
I was one of holding the string. She was supposed to sit like that. I was trying to bend the chair. She just felt like this. Her neck touched ground.
Oh God. Am I a nigga? I want a baby girl.
So if people not give us whiskey, people are giving us this wine. Wine will not be anything.
Pinta.
My big baby.
That's what I say.
Ago egba mo ga vaka nyan ko nya akọ family ni asia bi mo ko nya gboglo di vanami ti o gana na nigeria ma gboglo nya de kanami odin de so gboglo na nya do bo nya gboglo ali hoho. Yes, my name is Asiabi Melanie Comfort, and today I bring to you our Ghanaian stories. For a very, very long time, it has died out. I'd like to speak about few ones on the gang reality show. I'd like to congratulate my fellow housemates for making it to the top six. It is not an easy thing. So congratulations to all of us. Congratulations. Story.
Story.
Once upon a time.
Time.
There lived a man called Koko Anansi and his father. His father was a big king in the village of Chotroso. This man has wisdom and knowledge of every little thing that goes on in the village. So he called his son one day. Anansi, Koko Anansi. The son said, "Yes, father, here I come. My son, I want to give you a gift. And this gift contains wisdom and knowledge and has to be passed on to generation unto generation." Anansi said, "Okay, father, give me that gift." The father took a pot. And this pot is full of wisdom in it. He said, "My son, this is the pot of wisdom, filled with knowledge from our ancient days. Take it, learn, discover, and use anything you see in this magic pot." So, the title of our story is Coco and Nancy in the magic box. In this village where few people, just few people, like we are sitting here today, very few of us. In this village, the only person who has wisdom was the king. So, with this pot, he has to pass it out to people. The end of that pot is his tribe. He is the last person to have that pot in their family. Kokoanansi got that pot, my dear sisters. He discovered a lot of things from that pot. The few things he discovered is the magic to turn things into existence. Like a stone, he can turn it to anything he wants. His father has no knowledge about that. Immediately he discovered that, he called his father. Father, father, I have discovered a lot and I would like to show it to you. The father appeared. He's like, daddy, this pot, I can be able to turn things into existence. The father was so happy and so joyous. You know that feeling you get when you are teaching someone something and it's like the person is having the knowledge of it? That is exactly how the man felt. He's like, my son, I am proud of you. So tell me, how do you intend to pass this knowledge to the few people in your village? Guess what the son said? No, daddy, that knowledge is mine. I discovered it myself. The father was very disappointed and didn't know what to do. But as a father, first mistake is not a mistake. Second mistake is not a mistake. But a third mistake means you are knowingly doing what is happening. The father didn't utter a word and he said, my son, do whatever that pleases you. So Coco and Nancy did whatever pleased him, not knowing the father was actually telling him something he has no idea about. Yes, in a nutshell, Coco and Nancy was still playing with the sports and he realized he could even take two stones together and take a fire out of the stone. He was able to gather some wood and then there was a light. He called out, father, father. The father appeared. And there, the father was so proud of him. He's like, my son, I am very happy you are learning and discovering things. How do you intend to pass this knowledge to the people in your village? No, father, I won't do it. I will not share this knowledge. The knowledge is solely mine and mine only. The father felt disappointed the second time again. So he disappeared. When he got to the third time, the father was so disappointed. He's like, Coco and Nancy, you have been banished from this village. Till you have the knowledge of what I really want you to do, don't ever return to this village again. Because of the little understanding Coco Anansi had, he flew away with the pots with him. The father asked, Coco Anansi, where is the pot I gave you? Daddy, I had the pot at a very long distance you can never find. He was lying, my dear. He had the pot right where he was. Immediately, the father turned away. He took the pot and went as the father said. As Coco and Nancy was on his way going, he felt very, very thirsty. He didn't know what to do. You have a wisdom pot. Why can't you fetch water from your wisdom pot? If all wisdom are gathered in that pot, he couldn't get that wisdom. That wisdom is out of his hand now because he can't think again. He met a little child. Sorry to say, that child was damp, fetching water from the streams. So the little child offered water to Coco and Nancy to drink. He drank it so fast because he was very tired and needed that water the most. After the little child offered that water to Coco and Nancy, he continued his journey again. That little child followed Coco and Nancy, step by step, right behind him. He stopped and asked, "Little one, what are you doing right behind me?" All he could say is, "Coco," because he can't speak. "Coco." He took a step forward again. The child followed again. Coco and Nancy was walking and saw a very huge tree that he can actually hide the pot of wisdom up there, so no one could get it. He was climbing the tree. "Tell me how possible you could climb a tree with a pot, not being afraid that that pot is going to fall and break." So he didn't know what to do. And you know what the little child did? He took the rope that he was using to fetch water. He tied it up and he's like, "Coco." With the little wisdom Anansi had, he realized that he's supposed to tie that pot behind him with the rope and can be able to climb that tree. The child was playing a play. There is a play we use a sand to move the house. That was exactly what the child was doing. After Coco and Nancy, for a long while, was able to climb that tall tree, he realized that the child was still under the tree. He said, "I will hide this pot so that even this child will not find where the pot is." My friends, Coco and Nancy stood there for a long while, watching the kid doing his own thing, not paying attention to know where he keeps the wisdom pot. Then something changed all of a sudden. He said, "What a wonderful world," Coco and Nancy said. "What a wonderful world. This child is so clean, has nothing against me, not fighting for my pot, not wanting to know where the pot is going to be placed. He has few knowledge about what exactly he is doing, but he is just helping because he needed the help." Coco and Nancy got down from the tree with the magic pot on his back, stood there for some time, watched the child, and then told the child, "You have taught me some sense. So I'll have to teach everybody in my village how the magic pot is helping me to know little things about reality." So Anansi changed from his greediness. He took the pot and threw it away in the stream. And you know how stream it flows without knowing where it is going. That is how knowledge was spreaded in the village of Coco and Nancy. He went back to apologize to his father and told his father he is ready to share his knowledge to his people. Wisdom, knowledge, understanding was shared to Coco and Nancy's village. Now, that is the story behind how human beings can't think the same way in this life. Some people have wisdom and understanding. Some people have knowledge. Some people even know how to calculate their steps when they want to get something. So this story is how far I could go with Coco and Nancy's story to you. Wisdom was shared unknowingly and knowingly through Coco and Nancy to the whole world by just a lesson taught by a little child. My friends, if you have anything that belongs to you, sharing it with someone doesn't mean it's never yours. It is yours. You own it. And nobody can take something that God has freely given to you away from you. Whatever wisdom that is yours and can never be taken away from you, my sisters. Do you understand what I just said? And I want to know the knowledge and understanding and the lesson you have learned from this whole story I have told you. I will start from Jessica. What did you learn from this story?
One simple rule: sharing, giving. Like what you said, whatever is yours, even though you share it, it doesn't mean it's not yours. And it will not leave you to the next person.
Diara, my friend.
Okay, so I learned that sharing is good. And I also learned that by shining or having something and getting to share doesn't mean that you two would not be seen. Because in the case of Kuku Ananti, maybe he felt that having a knowledge and sharing with others would make him less relevant. But having a knowledge or having something and sharing with others cannot and does not make you less relevant.
Okay. Baby best.
I learned that obedience and love moves together. And understanding too. Without them, Kuku Ananti cannot remember to go back to their village to tell them the secret thing that he find out from the pot.
And my beautiful, beautiful black attitude.
I learned two lessons. The first one is that in life, sometimes when you try to take something away from people, or from a child, or from anybody, or friend, or whatever, if you go about it forcefully, they might not be able to, they might turn against you and not be able to see the lesson to it. So what I learned from this story, the first lesson is that in life, sometimes you have to let people go through life, learn things on their own and be able to realize what is best for them. Because the best truth and the best lesson is the one you learn on your own. For instance, a child going to a fire and you're telling the child to go away from the fire, the child might not understand it is from a place of love. You are telling the child not to go to the fire. The child will go to the fire until sometimes you have to let people make mistakes. At least the one that you know that will not kill them or hurt them, for them to be able to learn the lessons from life. Secondly, I also learned that you can learn from anybody. You can learn from both the old, the young. Just be open to learning and don't ever allow pride deprive you from learning something that will be beneficial to you. So in the case of this story, those are the two lessons I learned.
Okay. And this is how we have come far. I have also learned that greediness is not what it has to be. When you are greedy, you miss opportunity of a lot of things. Share freely, give freely, live freely, and everything will come right directly to you because of your pure heart that you have. Thank you very much for this story that you all have listened to, and this is the Gang Reality Storytelling Time. Thank you.